You ready to go shopping? Step inside a very special supermarket. The only supermarket in the world that gives you money. £2,000 is waiting on our shelves to be won by some lucky person in this store. The aim of the game is to shop smarter and faster than the next person. And everything in this supermarket is up for grabs. Go on, fill your trolley as high as you can, because shopping has never been so much fun. Yes, there's prizes in store and much, much more when you play Supermarket Sweep. So let's welcome today's shoppers, who are Susan and Jenny from Bristol. Jared and Steve from Tyne and Wear. And Helen and Val from Kent. You're all on Supermarket Sweep. And here's your host, Dale Winton.
Good morning, teams. Good morning to you and welcome to Supermarket Sweep. One of our teams could be going home today with £2,000. What they have to do is prove their shopping skills and knowledge by building up valuable minutes and seconds on their clocks, which they then take with them out into the market to go wild through the aisles. The more time they have, the more shopping they can do. To get you started, let me give you all 1 minute. There you go. And as a little taster of what you'll be doing later on, we'll run a mini sweep. This is your chance to add an instant 10 seconds to your clocks and a possible £25 to your sweep total. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
Good. Here we go. What product am I looking for? It comes in a container and is full of vitamins, especially if freshly squeezed. Jared.
Orange juice.
Sounds right, and it is. 10 seconds. I've just added 10 seconds to your clock. As you answer the question correctly, Jared, Steve, you're going to run the mini sweep. Somewhere out in the market is a jar or a bottle of freshly squeezed orange juice bearing this logo. Mm-hmm. If you bring it to me within 30 seconds, I'll add £25 to your sweep total. Are you ready?
Yes.
Off you go. Go on! Steve! Steve, come and say hello. You did very, very well and very entertaining. Very entertaining, that. It was a good start to my day, I have to tell you. But you see, the clue was freshly squeezed. Which you find in the chill cabinet.
Oh, right.
Never mind, you did very well. You got 10 seconds. Go back and join Jared while I get to know the other members of the team. You have the 10 seconds anyway, so what a difference. Jenny and Susan, good morning.
Good morning, Dale.
How are you both?
Fine, thank you.
Now, how do you know each other?
We're friends.
We're friends for how long, Jenny?
About 6 years now.
Right, okay. And what about getting onto this programme today, getting into our market? Whose bright idea was that?
Mine.
You take responsibility,
yes.
Jenny.
Yes.
Are you a Swift shopper when you're out and about?
About 3 hours, yes.
3 hours. We can't have 3 hours here today. But you'll do well. I wish you lots and lots of luck, both of you, on Supermarket Sweep. Steve and Jared, good morning.
Good morning. Good
morning, Dale.
Now, I know that you're still out of breath, aren't you, there?
A little bit.
I'll talk to Jared first. Jared, you met Steve at work because you're both, is it gaming inspectors?
Yeah, game inspectors, sorry.
Please excuse my ignorance. What does that actually mean that you have to do?
Well, what we do is we actually like referee roulette and blackjack games, solve any disputes, check bets, stuff like that. Just basically umpire the game.
Right, so it's sort of like a croupier who looks after the scores.
That's it, where you become a croupier and then you get promoted up after a few years.
Do you enjoy what you do?
It's all right, yeah, I get by.
Well, I'd find it sort of deeply worrying to watch all that money being just disappearing.
Yeah, I could do with some myself, like. But,
yeah. What about you, Steve? Do you enjoy what you do? Because you do the same job, don't you?
And you get to see some very big wins, and a lot of people have a lot of runs of good luck.
Yeah.
Mind you, my wages are paid as well.
Good, good. Well, you never know. You might have a really good run of luck today. I hope you do. Welcome to the suite.
Thanks, Dale.
Helen and Val, good morning.
Good morning, Dale.
Now, which one of you two has got a passion against men that rattle change in their pockets?
Me. Can't stand it.
Well, I haven't got any in my pocket.
Oh, good.
Why is it so annoying to you?
I don't know. It just really bugs me because they stand next to you in queues and jangle it, you know, like as if they've got lots
of
money in. Or yeah, it really winds me up.
They're just trying to draw their attention, you know.
Probably,
trying to.
Yeah.
That's all it is. Hi, Val.
Hi.
Now, how do you know Helen?
She's my sister-in-law.
Right. Okay. Well, welcome to the suite.
Thank you very much.
I know that one of you wanted to be Goldie Hawn, who thinks she's absolutely fabulous.
Yeah,
is that you?
Yeah.
She's a pretty zany, unusual character. Yeah, what is it about her that you like so much?
I just think she's a really brilliant actress, you know. And I thought she was really, really good in Overboard. That was my favourite film.
In what?
Overboard.
I never saw that movie.
Oh, it's really good. Yeah. She sort of played a snob at the beginning and then went on, you know, to be sort of quite common.
Not like Hyacinth Bouquet,
really,
then, obviously.
No,
the other way around. Welcome to Supermarket Sweep. I wish you lots of luck.
Thank you very much.
What we'll do is we'll play a game, but Jenny, Jared and Val, if you'd like to take a break, we'll welcome Susan, Steve and Helen to the front for our first game. OK. We call this game After. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you three words, and there's one word which would fit appropriately after all three. I'll give you an example of what I mean. If I said to you, cheese, ham and beef, I'm hoping you tell me the word was burger. Cheeseburger, hamburger, beefburger. You get the idea? It's very easy. We've got a possible 40 seconds for you to make on this one. So let's have the first one. Here it is. Garden, processed. Steve.
Peas.
Sounds right. And it is. 10 seconds. You all went for it together. Steve got there first. Here's another one. What is this? Cocktail. Steve.
Shaker.
Let's see if you're right. Cumberland. Helen.
Sausage.
That could be right, and it is. 10 seconds. It is very tempting to buzz in, but sometimes it pays, sometimes it doesn't. Never mind, here's another one for you. Raw. Spring. Susan.
Onion.
It's right, 10 seconds. And you all went for it at the same time. My goodness. Here's another one for you. Red. Steve.
Wine.
Let's see if you're right. Just out of curiosity, what would the third one have been? Obviously red, white, and what would the third? Never mind, let's have another one. Red, ground, Helen.
Pepper.
That's right, the other one being black pepper. Yeah, well done. Let's have a look at your clocks. Well, Susan, you have 1 minute and 10 seconds. Steve and Helen, you both have 1 minute and 20. We're going to go all around the world now. I want you to imagine this is a supermarket in many parts of the world. Might even be in a different part of the United Kingdom. And I'm sending you a postcard. You have to tell me where I am, where the cards come from. A possible 30 seconds for you to make on this one. And the first one I can tell you is from a city. In which city am I? Sauerkraut and strudel are some of the many dishes. Steve.
Munich.
Let's see if you're right. Of one of the many dishes you would expect to find in this totally westernised city. Helen.
Berlin.
Let's see if you're right. Yeah, 10 seconds. Which city am I in? If you like chips, you may not like this the way they are served with mayonnaise. So little time and yet so many bridges to cross. This delightful city has lots of... Steve.
Amsterdam.
That's right, 10 seconds. And finally, which city am I in? Clam chowder is a favourite local dish. They say fall is the best time to visit this area of the United States. Steve.
Wrong. Paris.
Let's continue. Everyone is so friendly when you go in a bar, everyone says, cheers. Must be popular, for they once... Helen.
Chicago.
Let's see if you're right. Must be popular, for they once had a tea party here. You still have time, Susan. And Steve wanted to go for it again. He can tell us. Go on, Steve.
Boston.
Boston was the right answer. I can't give you the 10 points, but well done. Let's bring back your partners. Let's have a look at what time you have on your clocks. Well, Jenny and Susan, you have 1 minute and 10 seconds. Jared and Steve, you have 1 minute and 30. And Val and Helen, you also have 1 minute and 30. C Susan, Steve and Helen, we will see you later for the round robin, but returning players, step forward, we're going to play a game now. Right, here's a chance for all of you to pick up half a minute, a full 30 seconds with one answer. Here's how it works. If one of you gives me the correct answer, I'll give you 10 seconds. If all three of you agree on the answer and that answer is correct, I'll throw in a bonus 20 seconds, making a full half a minute. One of these items you see in front of me is on sale in our market for less than £1. I want to know which one it is. Now, could it be the silk fabric conditioner? Could it be the washing up liquid? Or could it be the lemon liquid cleaner? Which one of these is on sale for less than £1? Please make your choices. OK, Jenny, which one did you decide cost less than a pound?
Number one.
Number one, the fabric conditioner. Jared?
Number two.
Number two, the washing up liquid. And Val?
Number two.
Number two, the washing up liquid. Let me tell you. Number one, the fabric conditioner is on sale in our supermarket today for £1.29. The washing up liquid is £1.15. The answer I was looking for, of course, is the lemon liquid cleaner, 95 pence. So three was the one I was looking for. But never mind, let's check out those scores again. 1 minute and 10 seconds for Jenny. Jared, you have 1 minute and 30. And Val, you have 1 minute and 30. It goes like that sometimes. That's the way it goes. Let's play another game. This one's called Scrambled Letters. I'm going to give you the answer, but I'm going to scramble all the letters up. You have to unravel those letters to give you the right answer I'm looking for. To help you along the way, I'll supplement it with up to five clues. Buzz in as soon as you know what the word should be. OK? And a possible 50 seconds to be made on this round. Here's your first one. Delicate. Leaves. Black. Indian. Jenny.
Darjeeling.
I think that's right, and it is. 10 seconds. You look surprised. Let's have another one.
I am.
Dried. French. Breath. Smelly. Seasoning. Jenny.
Garlic sausage.
Let's see if you're right. Jared and Val, you can still buzz in, there's still time. Dried, French, breath, smelly, seasoning. Let's unscramble those letters. Garlic granules, that's the one I was looking for. Ah, couldn't you cook yourself now? I know what it's like. Let's have another one. South American Bogota Dark. Jenny.
Colombian coffee.
That could be right, and it is. 10 seconds. Here's another one for you. Can, shirt, collar, ironing. Jenny.
Starch spray.
There speaks someone who's used to dealing with this stuff. And here's your last chance for 10 seconds in the scrambled letters game. Have a look at this one. Pubs. Coloured, breadcrumbs, fry, seafood. Pubs, coloured, breadcrumbs, fry, seafood. Jenny.
Golden scampi.
It certainly is. 10 seconds, well done. Let's bring back your partners for the round robin. Let's have a look at those clocks again. Well, Steve and Jared, you have a minute and 30. Helen and Val, you also have a minute and 30. And you did very well out of that last round. Susan and Jenny, you have 1 minute and 50. For the round robin, you take it in turns to give me a correct answer. Returning players, we're going to hear from you first, so step forward. Let's play the round robin. We call this the food and drink round. Buzz in as soon as you know the product or item I'm looking for. Here we go. And this, incidentally, is your last chance to add a full minute to your clocks. Six questions worth 10 seconds apiece. What is a Chinese dish made with pineapple syrup and usually eaten with pork? Steve.
Sweet and sour sauce.
You know it so well. And it's such a complicated question, isn't it? I know, change. What are crepe Suzette? Jenny.
Pancakes.
They certainly are. 10 seconds, change. Which country does Chianti wine come from? Steve.
Spain.
No, it doesn't. Helen.
Italy.
Certainly does. 10 seconds, change. Besides fruit, What is the principal ingredient of a summer pudding? Jenny.
Bread.
It is too. 10 seconds. Change. What kind of fruit is a beauty of Bath? Helen.
Peach.
It's not actually. Steve and Susan, do you want to buzz in? Steve.
An apple.
An apple, it is. 10 seconds. Change. I have to watch my pronunciation on this one. Which drink is Jerez, or Jerez as some people pronounce it, in Spain famous for? Jenny.
Wine?
No, that's not quite the answer I was looking for. Amontillado, sweet and dry, are all types of this drink.
Tequila.
Jared.
Tequila.
No, that's not quite the right answer either. Val, you can have a go, still time.
Can't think.
And Helen wants to tell you too. It's sherry. Never mind. OK, well, let's have a look at the time, see how much time you'll be taking with you out there into the market as we end the round robin. Well, as I see that Helen and Val, you have 1 minute and 40. Steve and Jared, you have 1 minute and 50. And Susan and Jenny, you have 2 minutes and 10 seconds. However, I mean, it doesn't matter how much time you are. If you're tactical when you're rushing around the supermarket, it depends how well you do when you're picking the expensive items. Sometimes time doesn't mean as much as you think it might do. But out of each team, which one of you is running the sweep? Susan, Steve and Val. Come back in a few moments as we watch those three chase around the aisles and going wild to load their trolleys, hopefully going for the chance to win £2,000. Welcome back to Supermarket Sweep. Now's the time we see just how well our teams do with the time they've been given. OK, well, let's have a look at how much time they do have. Susan and Jenny, you have 2 minutes and 10 seconds. You'll be going first. Steve and Jared, you have 1 minute and 50. And Val and Helen, you have 1 minute and 40. The team that shops the best, in other words, brings back the highest shopping total, will go for the £2,000. OK, you ready for that? Everything in the supermarket is yours for the taking. Grab what you will. Well worth mentioning my shopping list. If you pick up all three items on the list, I'll add a further £100 to your subtotal. Here's what's on today's list. A bunch of bananas, a jar of multivitamin tablets, and a tin of black treacle. You bring back one of each item, I'll add, as I say, £100 to your subtotal. Also, keep an eye out for the inflatable bonuses. They're worth between £25 and £100. Only one to a customer, but if you see one, just grab it and throw it in the trolley. Are you ready to go shopping?
Yes!
Good. Susan and Jenny, you're going to go first. I'm going to count you in. 3, 2, 1, go!
Away goes Susan with a 20-second advantage. Heading straight off for the items on Dale's shopping list. That's the bunch of bananas, the multivitamin tablets, and the treacle. That looks like the vitamin tablets. Are they the right ones? Come on, Susan, check it out. Maybe. Off goes Steve, sprinting into the fruit and veg. Got the bananas. Susan, I think, got the treacle there. Here's Steve, picked up the vitamin tablets. Change of heart, he's going back. Valerie's away, she's got the bananas as well. Steve got an ironing board and a bonus. Susan in amongst the washing powders. Valerie's left her trolley and just... And here's Steve, and there's Valerie. They're running all over the place. No trolleys, not a trolley in sight. Here's one, Steve picked his up. Went into the fruit and veg. Nice of him, tidying up on his way round. It's a banana bonus for Susan. Valerie still hasn't got a... Oh, where you off to, Valerie? No, it's not down there, is it? Yeah, oh, no, oh, hey! Yes, the vitamin tablets. She knew they were there somewhere. How's Susan doing? Pretty good, couple of hair dryers gone in. Here's Steve. Come on, my boy, that's it, get it up. He'd make a good dustman, that one. Here's Valerie.
Make a quiet moment with some new rolls.
Susan goes back for a new trolley. Off she goes once more into the market. Here comes our Steve. He's full up. Yep, just change him over, boy. Get him out again. There's Valerie. There's motor oil going in for Susan. Flasks. Here's Steve. It's me. He doesn't know whether he's coming or going. Oh, definitely not. Here's Valerie. She looks as though she's going. Back to the checkout. Ready Mills, last seconds, ticking away. And where's Valerie going? She's going on a mission, but I don't know what for. It doesn't matter. Time's out.
Come on back.
Where are you? Come on back. Thank you, Bobby, for taking us through those aisles so wonderfully. We're going to let Caroline, Sam and Justin run all these groceries through the till to find out which team is going to go for the £2,000. Let's add up those groceries now. All the sums have been done. Let's find out just who's going to go forward for the super sweep. Val and Helen, did you do my shopping list?
Yes, yeah. I did.
£100 on your subtotal. Any inflatable bonuses?
No.
No. Okay, fair enough. That's a subtotal of £100. Let's add that to the value of the shopping in your trolley, which gives you a supermarket sweep grand total today of £286. Well done. Yes. Stephen Jarrod, did you do my shopping list?
We did, dear.
£100, there you go. And how much is your bonus worth? Let's have a look. £25. A subtotal of 125. We'll add that 125 to the value of the shopping in your trolley, which gives you a grand total today of £271. Good. Susan and Jenny, what about the shopping list?
No.
2 out of 3, no £100, but the bonus, how much is that worth?
Oops.
£75, terrific. We'll add that £75 to the value of the shopping in your trolley. If it is worth more than £286, you're running the super sweep. If it isn't, Val and Helen, you're one running the super sweep. When we add that subtotal to the total value of the shopping, you get a total today of £270. Well done. Val and Helen, you're running the super sweep. Stephen, Jarrod, Susan and Jenny, you get a great parting gift. Thanks for being good shoppers. Have a good day.
Thank you.
A bit calm. You're a bit calm for us this morning. Oh. Right, well, this is it. Somewhere in this supermarket, there is £2,000 hidden in cash. I feel it's going to be yours. I want you to go home with it. You are going to do that. To find the money, you have to solve the three clues that will lead you to the three specially marked products. Your minute doesn't start until I finish giving you the first clue. You have a full minute to find the money. When you're eating bread and cheese, sweet Plowman's blank is sure to make a better sandwich. Go, 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 go.
Pickles, pickles, it's a long one. It's not a plum, it's not a peach, it tastes a little bit of it. But it's really because I think of a nectarine. A wedding cake to celebrate you've married Mr. Wright and something sugar makes a chocolate smoothie.
I'm going sugar.
Join us next time, and just remember, the next time you're at the checkout and you hear the beat, think of the fun you could be having on Supermarket Sweep. Have a wonderful day.